Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Lantern Sports Preview Show. I am your host, Curtis Grube, alongside my co-host, Kevin Lapka. Kevin, what does the matchup look like for this Saturday?
Week two for the Ohio State Buckeyes, number three ranked Ohio State Buckeyes, moved up two spots in that AP poll, taking on number 18, Penn State, on Halloween night. Happy Halloween to all the viewers out there. It is a 7:30 p.m. game in State College for ESPN's College Game Day. Big time matchup, Big Ten matchup here. Last time these two teams played actually was just last year. Ohio State victorious 28-17, but we're now going to take a look at the stats comparison for these two teams. Curtis, what do we have here for the offensive statistics?
Yeah, so if you look at points per game, we only have 1 week of sample size, but Ohio State have 52 points per game. And Penn State scored 35 points last week in their one-point loss against Indiana. If you take a look at total yards per game, Ohio State had 491 yards last week. Penn State, not too far behind, though, with 488. Now, they did have an overtime to rack up a little more yards per game, but 488, not too far behind. Kevin, what do the defensive stats look like?
Well, Curtis, you know I'm a defensive guy, right? So let's first take a look here at points allowed. Ohio State 17 in week one, good enough for 14th in the FBS. Penn State, not very good, 36, good enough for 78 in the FBS. But this is what I want to take note of, is Ohio State, their defense needs to focus on that bend, don't break mentality, because this is a better offense you're seeing in Penn State rather than, you know, Nebraska last week, okay offense, but not as good as Penn State is. So, you know, they're going to drive down the field, but if Ohio State can force turnovers, and even if Penn State does get in the red zone, if they can hold them to field goals, that is going to be very, very instrumental to Ohio State coming out with a victory in this game. But another statistic I want to look at that is also going to be very crucial is opponent third down conversion percentage. So Ohio State wasn't too good in week one. 40% opponent third down conversion percentage, good enough for 55th in the FBS. But on the contrary, Penn State, pretty dang good, 33%, 22nd in the FBS. So what Ohio State needs to not let happen is Penn State have long, extended, grueling drives where they're going to go down the field and wear that defense down, because that's going to be their goal. Third and eight, you can't let them get it. Third and three, you can't let them get it. Because when it comes down to the fourth quarter, late in the game, and Ohio State needs their defense to make a play, if they're worn down, you can't really rely on that if Penn State's been having these long extended drives and dominating the time of possession. So very, very important statistic there to look at. But we're going to go to a new segment now called Fact or Fiction, new segment for us. First question we have for Curtis is, Justin Fields, Ohio State's leading rusher. Curtis, is that fact or fiction?
Well, Justin Fields last week only had two plays that were actually quarterback design runs. And he also worked in the offseason on becoming a better pocket passer. And it obviously proved to be successful last week in Nebraska. He went 20 for 21 for pass attempts. So I am going to go fiction. I think that Trey Sermon and Master Teague will lead the rushing attack. Also, Penn State's defense last week against Indiana had Indiana's quarterback Michael Penix Jr. negative 18 rushing yards last week. So I think that Penn State is going to really focus on trying to contain Justin Fields, and I think that it's going to work for Penn State. So your fact or fiction question, Kevin, will Ohio State have more sacks than Penn State this Saturday? What do you think?
Yeah, I'm going to go fiction, and I do think Penn State will have more sacks, and here's why. Ohio State's offensive line ranks 88th in the FBS in sack rate at 10%, so that's not very good. When you're 88th in the FBS in anything, that's not where you want to be. So you look at the other side, Penn State's defensive line against that Ohio State offensive front, they rank 34th in the FBS in sack rate, so pretty good defensive front there. And Ohio State going up against Nebraska's defensive front last week, which is a little bit less talented of a unit in comparison to Penn State, still allowed three sacks. So this is going to be a matchup to look out for, that Ohio State offensive front versus that Penn State defensive front. So, you know, when Ohio State is in rhythm, you can't let the Penn State defensive line get in there and cause some sacks there, because that could, you know, very well change the course of a game. You know, it can stall drives. So I'm going to go fiction. I think Penn State will have a little bit of success against an Ohio State offensive line that, you know, needs to work out a few things after last week.
All right. Well, that's going to do it for us for the Lantern Sports pregame show. Make sure you look out for us after the show following Saturday's game. That will be on YouTube and all of our social medias. I'm Curtis Grube. That's Kevin Lapka. And we'll see you next week.